many years I had a dog named Al, a golden retriever with all the great characteristics of that breed. He was a fabulous dog, faithful, attentive, protector of my children, man's best friend. But he was a dog, and he would systematically, about once every 2 months or so, smell real badly. So he would get hosed off, and he was much more aromatically acceptable afterwards. Now that's kind of like what today's collect is about, getting cleaned up. We pray, actually we beg, we beseech God that he would give us, his faithful people, both pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all of our sins, and then serve him with a quiet, secure mind. Although it's only an aromatically pleasant change after an animal is cleansed, when you and I step out of the shower of God's pardoning, grace-filled forgiveness, having been washed and made clean by the body and blood of Christ, we're truly clean. We are new people. We're called to do God's will in life. Put into the allegorical words of today's epistle reading from Ephesians, we can then become strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. And he gives us a new outfit to wear. Now, Ephesians is not talking about temporal clothing. It's not about choosing between Brooks Brothers and JCPenney. It's an inward, spiritual dressing. It is spiritual body armor. We will be clothed from head to toe with the whole armor of God and ready for the wrestling matches, the fights, the struggles, the pains, the anguishes that we all experience in life. We now have something, then, which draws us closer to God, stands us up straight, and strengthens us in order to glorify God. This new outfit is otherworldly, loins girt about with truth, a breastplate of righteousness, feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace, the shield of faith, the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit. Now, that's an outfit. And then we're told to pray, after we put all this on, to pray for all the saints also. And then the writer of the epistle asks the Ephesians to pray for him, that he may open his mouth boldly to make known the mystery of God. Listen, in point of fact, we all have a calling to boldness. If you are Christ's, you are called to be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. You too will be bold. If you've got on this outfit that we're talking about, you can't be a Casper Melktoast, can you? Having said that, however, there is a very powerful temptation for us all, clergy also, to somehow try to disguise ourselves to others for fear of having to speak boldly in Christ. And so we don't talk much about the faith oftentimes. Even when someone in our midst is spitting on Christianity, Christians, or the church. Why do we do that? Because there's always a price to be paid. We know that. There is a war going on. Today we hear from Scripture, we wrestle against principalities and powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. We all know that. And sometimes we are tempted to become fearful. Fear not. Don't be afraid. Even though the archetype of Christian boldness, John the Baptist, had his head chopped off for speaking boldly, don't worry. No one is going to chop your head off. That's just too Neanderthal. We've progressed beyond such banality. Today, the method of operation is name-calling, ridicule, character assassination, social embarrassment. And if you really get someone mad at you, perhaps litigation. All very efficient, effective ways the devil and his friends in the 21st century use in their attempts to get Christians to hold back on the truth, to sit down, to slump down and cower, rather than standing up for righteousness, truth, God, Jesus. So there is a powerful message for us in today's Proverbs. In the midst of the pains and anguish and wrestlings of life, Jesus stands ready to give pardon and peace, to cleanse us from our sins, to heal and raise us up, and enable us to do him service with a quiet, steady mind and a bold and powerful witness. We need only to come to him, as the nobleman did in today's gospel narrative, and ask for his healing and his miraculous presence. Where Christ is, new life is given. Are times tough? Sure they are. But there's a saint who can help us put things into perspective, St. Francis de Sales. He boldly proclaimed about life, "Let the world turn upside down. Let everything be in darkness, in smoke, in uproar. God is with us. Be bold. Christ is with you. Be bold all the way to and through Golgotha if need be. People are praying for you. I'm praying for you. Pray for me too, that I may likewise be bold for the sake of the gospel." See you next week.